There are some probability distributions that come up over and over again in statistics and machine learning. I thought it'd be worthwhile to take a few minutes and talk through a couple of them. These are going to be one-dimensional distributions, but they all have multivariate generalizations. These are kind of reference distributions whose properties we understand pretty well and that we like to combine together to make more complicated things. Our starting point is the simple Bernoulli distribution. This is the sort of distribution you would get from a biased coin. The associated random variable takes values 0 or 1, and it has a single parameter. That parameter reflects the probability of getting a 1, and here I'm denoting it as rho. Imagine that you had n Bernoulli random variables, each with a probability rho. Their sum has its own name, called the binomial distribution. So the binomial distribution has two parameters, rho and n, and it can take values between 0 and n inclusive. It's a common way to think about binary counts when you don't care about the order that the counts arrived in. The multinomial distribution generalizes the binomial when the underlying random variables take more than two values. The Poisson distribution is of fundamental importance in a wide variety of areas, from physics to networking to neuroscience. It arises as the result of a memoryless process in continuous time in which the expected number of events per unit time is held constant. So think photons or neural spikes or packets in a network. Poisson random variables take values in the non-negative integers. There is a single parameter, usually denoted lambda, that needs to be positive and is the expectation of the distribution. Another distribution with support over the non-negative integers is the geometric distribution. Like the binomial, you can think of this as arising from a sequence of Bernoulli random variables. In this case, it corresponds to the number of coin flips, say, that you need until you get to your first heads. Like the Bernoulli, it has a single parameter rho. When our random numbers can take values on the real line, our workhorse distribution is the Gaussian or normal distribution. It's difficult to overstate how important the Gaussian distribution is to all kinds of fields, from physics to econometrics. Part of the reason it's so fundamental is due to the central limit theorem. The central limit theorem essentially shows that if you have a sum of almost any other kind of random variable with a finite mean and variance, that sum will converge to a Gaussian distribution asymptotically. In a lot of different scientific domains, we often want to talk about aggregates, whether they're particles or people, and when we talk about aggregates of many, many different things acting randomly, then we would expect those aggregates to converge to a Gaussian distribution. In one dimension, it has two parameters, a mean, typically denoted mu, and a variance, often written sigma squared. The Gaussian distribution has what are called light tails, that is, the probability of being very far away from the mean is pretty small. Sometimes we might want to have a distribution with heavier tails, that is, with higher probability of being farther away from the mean, for outlier type events. One common such distribution is the Laplace distribution. Laplace random variables take their values in the reals, and the distribution has two parameters, a mean and a scale, which I'm writing here as b. The Gaussian density drops off rapidly with the square of your distance from the mean, whereas the Laplace distribution only drops off with the absolute value of the distance from the mean. Another important class of distributions have support only for positive real numbers. Like the Gaussian and the Poisson, the exponential distribution comes up in a wide variety of natural phenomena. Most notably, the inter-arrival times of memoryless processes are exponentially distributed. The exponential distribution has one parameter, typically denoted lambda, referred to as the rate parameter. The gamma distribution is a bit more flexible, but also defined on the positive reals. It's called the gamma distribution because the gamma function appears in its normalization constant. If you haven't heard of the gamma function before, you should think of it as just the continuous generalization of the factorial. There are a couple of different parameterizations of the gamma distribution. Here I'm showing you the popular alpha and beta parameterization. The gamma distribution actually contains the exponential distribution as a special case, but it allows the mode to be somewhere other than zero. If you've encountered the chi-squared distribution before in statistics, it is also a special case of the gamma distribution. The beta distribution is another distribution that's inexplicably named after its normalization constant. The beta function is closely related to the gamma function from before. The key characteristic of the beta distribution is that it only has support between 0 and 1. It takes two parameters, both of which must be positive real numbers. The beta distribution comes up most often when you want to model the uncertainty associated with the parameter of another distribution, such as a Bernoulli. And then finally, we come back around to a very simple distribution, the uniform distribution. The uniform distribution here is specified by its endpoints, and it has equal density between those two endpoints and zero everywhere else. I'm writing its probability density function here as an indicator function that is 1 if the value x is between a and b and 0 otherwise. So that's just a few different distributions that I think are useful. It's by no means complete. These are just some simple distributions that are good building blocks for other things, whose properties you can easily look up on Wikipedia, and that are easy to sample from using tools like Python.